الحمد لله الحمد لله رب العالمين الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلا هادي له ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما صدق الله العظيم وقال الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم قال بني الإسلام على خمس شهادة أن لا إله إلا الله وأن محمد رسول الله وإقامة الصلاة وإيتاء الزكاة وحج البيت وصوم رمضان صدق الله. We praise and we thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who has created us and has provided for us not only for our creation but to sustain us to fulfill the very plan that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has planned and has designed that the mankind and the jinn kind among the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we will understand and appreciate Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We praise and we thank Him for His mercy in that He has guided us, in that He has opened our hearts to Islam. We praise and we thank Him for all the mercies and kindness. We do not deny any of His boons or His favors. We praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and we thank Him and we remind ourselves that the best thing that we can do is to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who created us from a single person and then from his mate and then from the two of them scattered multitudes of men and women throughout this world. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminds us that O people who understand why you are here, مَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ, that you should make submission, you should submit yourself to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Fear Allah and obey Allah and His Messenger and do not die except in this state. And O people who believe, be careful as to the way you use your tongue. Be careful and be mindful of the things that you do. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mercies and bounties is in abundance for us. And we praise and thank Him and we remind ourselves that the best thing of our lives, the best thing that can happen to us is to have a heart that remembers Allah and fear Him. Amma ba'd. Today inshallah, I wish to remind myself anew about a very important, the most important resource that was given to us. The believers, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has left with us that Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam brought it and he left it with us. It is the most important resource that we have. We are going to try to look at this resource and to see how we use it. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم Utlu ma uhiya ilayka al-kitab. Utlu ma uhiya ilayka min al-kitab wa akim as-salah. Inna as-salata tanha 'anil fahsha'i wal munkar. Wala dhikrullahi akbar. Wallahu ya'lamu ma tasna'un. This resource that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made available to us, my dear respected brothers and sisters, as-salah. The prayers. What is the prayer? What is the importance or the value of this institution? The Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tells us that the deen, al-Islam, it is built on five pillars, the foundations of it. And the second of it is the establishing of the prayers. In this verse that we find, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminds us, and by the way, this verse is found in Surah 29 and Kabut, verses, I think it's verse 45 or 46 in some. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, recite of the book, that which Allah has sent for us, the revelation that He has given to us, and establish the prayer. Inna salata tanha 'anil fahsha'i wal munkar. For the prayer prevents from shame and injustice. We're going to hold at that point for now. Let us look at this institution, my dear brothers and sisters, who have this opportunity, who among the people of this world has this privilege of prayers, of the salah. Only the believers. To make things a little simpler, let us look to what Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam have said to his companions in one of the reports that have reached us, and the comparison that he had made with the salah. Remember the desert in the time of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and even today, the condition of the desert is, we all know, it's hot, it's sand, it's sweaty, the humidity, everything puts it together. It is scarce. Water is scarce. There's scarcely water except for where the privileged areas are. And one day, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in talking to his companions, he asked them about a situation, talking about a person, making an example. What about a person who lives, and in front of him, in front of his house, in front of his door, there is water flowing, there is a stream flowing. Imagine the desert. Imagine the conditions of the desert. And now the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is saying, imagine there is a stream flowing in front of your door. My dear brothers and sisters, let us imagine that condition. What would have happened to the hearts of the believers of that time, the companions of the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? How eager they would have become on hearing about a house and a person living, and in front of his door there is a stream running. And he said, continuing, and this person, he dips himself in this stream, in this water, five times daily. Question, would there be any dirt left on him? Would there be any dirt left on such a person? They said, O Messenger of Allah, most likely no dirt will be left on him. And he said to them, in comparison, this is a similitude. There is an example of your prayers. Five daily prayers. So let us look quickly about the conditions of the believer who has this institution. The Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he tells us the prayer is the miraj of the believers. And what is the miraj? We all know it is that time when Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was taken to the presence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he had communications with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. My dear brothers and sisters, this is our salah that Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam have brought for us from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that we should establish it 5 times daily. If we will just take a little bit more quickly, how do we take a bath? How do we dip ourselves in the water, in the stream, to remove that which has attached itself to us, the dirt of the time? Keep in mind this example and this effort. So now we ask the question for myself and you. How do we approach our salah? How do we go to our salah? The Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said more or less, do not rush to the salah. Do not run to your salah. If the prayer begins, then take your time, approach the salah and complete what you missed. There is a point in this narration also. It is telling us, in preparing for our salah, give ourselves enough time. So this institution, if this resource that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has left with us through the beloved Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it has in it that which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have said, that the salah, the establishment of the salah, it is the dhikr of Allah, wala dhikrullahi akbar. It is for the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and in it we do those things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has commanded us to do through His Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. My dear brothers and sisters, what are the dirt of today? What are the things that affect us, like the heat and the dust and the conditions of the desert would affect those people, that they marvel or they dream and they are willing to be that fortunate person who has a stream running in front of their door so that they can clean themselves, they can shower, they can refresh. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tells us something, that between each salah, whatever little mistakes we make, whatever unfortunate things we might do, the sins, simply put, that we commit, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He would remove that between the Fajr and the Dhuhr, and the Dhuhr and the Asr likewise. And between one Jummah to the other, as well as from one Ramadan to the next, and if we make Hajj inshallah, then we are clean. This cleanliness that is talked about by the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it is of our conduct. To clean ourselves from what kind of dirt, from what kind of soil, from what kind of unpleasantness, from what kind of discomfort, what affects us that now we can go into the shower and we can be refreshed within a few minutes and we can have air condition and we can be comfortable. But the other dirt that the Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam have explained to us, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says about those people who do not say, those who do not accept, those who do not submit, those who do not testify, ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah, they are unclean, and as such they are prohibited. They cannot go into the Haramain. They cannot go into Makkah, Medina within the bounds that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have said by His Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Why? What affects them? The first dirt, the big major sin or the major uncleanliness is that they deny Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and as such they disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in everything almost that they do. Me and you, what is our concern? What do we load upon ourselves in the society that we live? All the things that are given to us. Today we have technology, and we use that technology for our benefit. Do we ask ourselves how it is put together? No, we utilize it with the instructions that are given so that we have maximum benefit of technology. Take simply a mobile phone, a smartphone. We do not try to find out what are the intricacies of the combination and what is this and that inside of it. All we want to know, what makes it work, what sustains it, what keeps it going, so that we can get service, and so we continue to recharge and recharge, and we continue to learn more and more about how to get the best out of it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have sent beloved Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to teach us the prayer and to tell us about the prayer and to tell us what the power of this prayer is. Who do we approach in the prayer? How many of us take time to understand that when we are approaching the prayer, the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, do not rush to your prayer. Why? Because who we are approaching. And it is a condition as though you're going to be in Mi'raj with who? With Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allahu la ilaha illa huwa al-hayyul qayyum la ta'khudhuhu sinatun. He does not sleep nor slumber. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He's teaching us. He's well aware of everything that we do. And this salah is the source, it is the means, the resource that has been given to us. What do we need? What do we need to utilize this resource? Time. Ask ourselves, how much time do we give to our salah? How much attention do we pay to the approach of the salah? That the hour is coming for the prayer. Where will I be? What am I occupying myself with? What am I going to do? How much attention do we put to know that the one that we are going to stand before knows the secrets of our hearts and knows our thinking and everything? Therefore, what does it lead us to? For the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it leads us to good dealings. For the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it leads us to honesty. And everything that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have said about the believers, أَوْدُ بِاللَّهِ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ الرَّجِيمِ بِسْمِ اللَّهِ الرَّحْمَنِ الرَّحِيمِ وَالْعَسْ إِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ لَفِي خُسْرٍ إِلَى الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ. The amal, the actions of that person who testify, ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashhadu anna Muhammadur Rasulullah, and who established the prayers, his dhikr, his remembrance of Allah, which is the greatest thing, is there is a consciousness that will now begin to grow within him, that he begins more and more to understand, because that understanding, that guidance, it comes from Allah. That understanding, that inner feeling and understanding of the relationship between the believer and his Allah, his Lord, that comes through the prayer based on the dedication of this slave, of this ibadi, of this servant. my dear brothers and sisters, all of us who are sitting here, we have needs, but our needs are at different levels. We need different things. And the simple thing is, we all have a confidence that this need that I have can be fulfilled if I do certain things. That's our confidence, that we need to approach. What we approach, we need to get the resource so that this need can be fulfilled. Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he tells us from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that Allah has power over all things. Allah has power over all things. And when we stand before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the frame of mind to glorify Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to renew and to enhance our relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we approach that prayer like the person whose body is dirty and he approaches the stream. How does he go? He goes with his intention to be clean. He takes his scrubber, he takes his soap, he takes his shampoo, he takes his towel to dry himself, and he takes clean clothes. Because if we take a shower and we go back to the soiled clothes or the smelly, dirty clothes, what does that mean? The shower did not benefit us. So when we approach this salah, we go with our difficulties. Here we have people who are dying. We are asking Allah for mercy for them, that their graves become spacious. Here we have people who are sick. Here we have COVID and Delta and whatever else. Here we have people who would not listen. Here we have people with all kinds of problems. Where is the resource? We have to have the confidence. So when we approach Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we are approaching to clean the impurities of our iman, that which has been attaching ourselves to us. What are these things? These are the things that the Nabi have talked about. You and I know the most important of those to avoid are lies, deception. And the best, وَقُولُوا قَوْلًا سَدِيدًا يُسْلِحْ لَكُمْ عَمَّالَكُمْ وَيَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ ذُنُوبَكُمْ وَمَا يُتِئِ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَ فَقَدَ فَاذَ فَوْذًا أَذِيمًا. These verses are telling us something. And where it is coming from? From the prayer. My dear brothers and sisters, we only do have limited time. But there is one other important thing that I can share with you. Inshallah, there was a person among the people who used to approach the prayer in the time of the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and a person come to him, to the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and said to him, such and such a person comes and join us in the Fajr, but he's a thief. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, leave him. That which is good will overcome that which is bad. And after some time, that person eventually, he gave up that bad habit of stealing. Each and every one of us, let us identify what we have been dragging on for how many years that has been against the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the teaching of His Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Of late, there was a young brother, and there was a fight between his mom and his aunt. And I said to him, listen, this is your aunt, you have to make up. He says, I can't. And on the other side, his mom is sick. She's ill. She's suffering. May Allah have mercy upon her. She eventually passed away. He is asking that we make dua for his mom, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have mercy upon her and give her shifa, healing and long life. My dear brothers and sisters, each and every one of us have got to put that examination to ourselves. We are approaching Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala 5 times every day. We are reciting from Quran. We are making dua. But if this salah is not cleaning us like a shower, like a bath, like the man dipping in a stream, then brothers and sisters, if we are not letting go of those things that Allah dislike and His Messenger has asked us to shed from ourselves, if we cannot have a big enough heart to forgive, never mind how big that sin is, or that grievance against whoever have wronged us, then what are we doing? We are coming into the salah and we are putting on back our dirty clothes. The Messenger of Allah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam left a beautiful example for us. As we dip, we should be clean. And none of us will take a shower, refresh, and put on dirty clothes. So why should me and you continue to have bad habits? Continue to be neglectful of the prayer. Continue to not pay enough attention to the approach of the hour when we have to pray. To the environment, including our thoughts and our clothing and the place we pray. My dear brothers and sisters, let us reflect. This is a reminder intended not to put anyone down, for I myself have to struggle. Ask any brother or sister who is making an effort and they will tell you about their struggle, because the shaitan does not sleep. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He makes it easy for us to understand what we have in the prayer. He makes it that our hearts open to know when we approach Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He has power over all things. Over all things. There's so much to tell you and to remind myself about, but time does not allow. But finally, remember Musa. In the beginning of this verse, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us, "Utlu ma uhiya ilayka min al-kitab." So the first approach, recitation of the book, reciting Quran, waqim as-salah, establish the prayer. Inna salata tanhani al-fashai wal-munkar, wala dhikrullahi akbar. والله يعلم ما تصنعون بارك الله لنا ولكم في القرآن العظيم ونفعنا وإياكم بالآيات والذكر الحكيم أستغفر الله لي ولكم أجمعين إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله الحمد لله رب العالمين. الحمد لله الذي هدانا لهذا وما كنا لنهتدي لولا أن هدانا الله. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. My bad. One last reminder. In the beginning of any struggle, in the beginning of any struggle, there are always going to be difficulties and there are always going to be discouragement. We are not going to find the satisfaction. If you are going to start eating karaila for the first time, you wouldn't like it. But then when you know what benefits come from it, you begin to enjoy it. You begin to look forward to it. That's how the human system works. For our prayer to really become the thing, like Hazrat Ali, when he used to stand in prayer, then nothing around him matters. This is the struggle for all of us. Brothers, we have to start. Keep the timing of the prayer. Make effort to understand what we say in the prayer. Make sure our hearts and our environment are good. And be nice to our parents and blood relations. A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. Inna allaha wa malaikatahu yusalluna ala nabiyyi ya ayyuhalladhina amanu. صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد ربنا إننا آمنا فاغفر لنا ذنوبنا وقنا عذاب النار ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا وهب لنا من لدنك رحمة إنك أنت الوهاب اللهم اغفر لي ولوالدي ولمن تولد ولجميع المؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات الأحياء منهم والأموات إنك مجيب الدعوات برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين اللهم إنا على ذكرك وشكرك وحسن عبادتك أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون اذكروا الله يذكركم ودعوه يستجب لكم ولذكر الله تعالى أعلى وأولى وأعز وجل وحم وتم وأكبر وآخر دعوانا الحمد لله وأقيموا الصلاة.